Congratulations, I've seen the movie.
Oh, awesome. What did you think?
It was intense, man. It was very intense, So talk a bit about what crossed your mind when you first read this intense drama script by Jordan.
When I got it in an email, and I remember I was in my apartment, and I was like, oh, I have this audition tomorrow. I want to meet this director. Yeah. And I started reading it on my phone, and I remember right when I got it, I had turned on the shower, and then like I was on page 45, and I realized I should probably go turn the water off. So I mean, like, it hooked me immediately. And then once we got into it, everything Jordan said and his vision, which he executed perfectly, not perfectly, but executed really well. And I think, everything just worked.
You know, this movie also speaks about, you know, kids in lower income neighborhood and the desperation people have sometimes. Yeah. Talk a bit about what it's trying to convey.
Yeah, I mean, I growing up, I was around that all too much. You know, I know it all too well. So I think going into it, Jordan was like, you know, he cut all my lines out of the script, and he just said, go in, and in every scene, whatever comes out of your mouth, just commit to the character, and whatever comes out of you, that's Troy, that's your character. And so I got to just live in it, and because I know these guys, and it's underprivileged guys from the wrong sides of the tracks, guys who you know, don't got a dime to their name, and they're just doing their best to get by, and they're just kind of a product of their environment, and so whether they're bad or good, it doesn't matter. They're just trying to survive.
How scary is Pablo in this one? He's just so scary, man. He was intense.
Yeah, man. Like when you watch the scenes that I do with him, like the opening scene, it's like, that's all genuine. Woo. I mean, because you never knew what this motherfucker was gonna do. Like he would simultaneously do every take and hit all the same beats that you need to hit. But then yet within those beats and in those pivots, he would still be so explosive that at any moment this motherfucker would just trip out. And you're just kind of like, that explosiveness, I let it be real with me, because then it made my relationship to him seem so real. So man, he's explosive as it gets. He was very intense, and it was super, super fun working with him. Hey there, my name is Grant Harvey. You're watching Rama Screen.
Congratulations. I've seen the movie.
Hey! Oh, shivers. Did you enjoy it?
It was intense. It was intense.
Pretty intense.
Oh my goodness, I was on the edge of my seat.
The final moment, I remember in Tribeca, the audience applause, and this absolute silence, and like the scream of joy when that end happens. It's a good end.
Now, talk a bit about, you know, working with Jordan, trying to, as an actor, unleashing this character in this very intense drama, especially your character is a kid from lower income neighborhood trying to get by. What was your approach?
I mean, I had a month of preparation myself, and so I felt it was important to go to the actual places just to see what the socioeconomic group was like, where they existed, where they lived, who they had to buy their groceries from and stuff like that. And so I met a whole bunch of weird, crazy people, and you know, it was also quite dark. Like I saw, you know, three arrests, you know, people getting pushed onto the bonnets of cars, and in the space of 2 hours, I had like one woman come up to offer me drugs, you know. One person swear at me that because I was white, you know. So so that was like my first, I think one of the first sort of touches with what the world was, and that really came through because of our conversations revolving around what the tone of this story was, and the tone of the story was to be very real and raw and honest, and to almost have it feel like this is a guy who, like, for my character Beaver and for all of them, that these are people who could have just walked straight off the street, that we really believe that they are where they're from, you know. And I didn't come from abject poverty, and so, you know, going through that and seeing those people, that was important for the process. And then also the way Jordan works is quite unique, in that he wants you as the actor to kind of bring a lot more to it than I think probably most directors, and he wants to be surprised every take. And so what that means for you is that, like, he'll want you to come to set with jokes and stories and monologues and magic tricks or whatever you can to just inject the scene with something that he hasn't seen, that he didn't know. He was constantly saying, just don't say my lines. I want to hear something I don't know is coming. So I think that was another really important in on the story, you know.
So you got method.
No, I mean I think you just gotta know what story you're telling.
Yeah.
You know?
I hear you. So yeah. I asked Grant about this, I'm gonna ask you the same question. Yeah. Man, Pablo is super scary in this film.
yeah.
How was that working with him, man?
It was great. You know, it was so necessary for the story. It was a conversation that Pablo, Grant, and myself and Jordan had early on, that we need to believe that these kids are terrified of this man.
Yes.
You know, and the way that we can help this story, you know, reach its zenith and its climax is to keep pushing that line until, you know, our characters, you know, either stand up and change it or don't, you know. We're left with a choice of what we should or shouldn't do with this man. But and as far as working on set, it was the same way with Jordan. Like, I didn't know what was coming at me most takes. It was always very physical and fresh and so much energy, which it was a really great energy and I think necessary for this. And to be honest, made my job easy, you know, because I got to just play off him. So, yeah, really great.
Last question, if you don't mind, before you enjoy the night.
Yep.
Coming from Australia now, working in Hollywood, mm-hmm. Did you get a different impression from when you were in Australia about our industry here?
Oh, man, you come here with no idea. Absolutely deer in headlights. I'm starting to understand a bit more about it, but it's still a wild ride. It's pretty exciting. Thanks, man.